shown to his room. The house mother introduced Don to Jack Collier, one of his roommates. He was on hand to help Don with his unpacking. She had arranged for Jack to be around so Don would be more at ease. Jack, with his easy manner, made Don feel at home right away. They soon discovered that they had many interests in common. After unpacking, they put Don's name above his towel hanger for identification. Then they took a quick tour of the cottage, stopping first at the sunroom. Jack said that it was used for reading or looking at magazines, or maybe a place for a light snack at night. And sometimes it was used for study. They visited the living room next. Here, Jack explained they could entertain visitors, and in the evenings, the cottage gang assembled for a friendly get-together and for their usual bedtime devotional. Then Jack showed Don the workshop. They had handcraft tools and materials which were a lot of fun to work with. Here also was the shoe repair equipment. Some of the boys learned this very practical trade. Practice materials were plentiful, and so were the good-natured complaints of the fellows who had to use them. The second day at the home was a busy one for Don, Carolyn, and Janice. That morning, they visited the superintendent, who welcomed them to the campus and told them of something of life at the home. He explained to them that their new home was built and maintained by the Baptists of the state. Love gifts from churches and individuals were received regularly to support the children in the home. They were told that here they would find the security and love of a real home. No effort was ever spared to provide for the needs of all who lived on the campus. There would be time for work and time for play and time to make many new friends. But in turn, they would be expected to share certain responsibilities and cooperate with the staff in making the home a happy and orderly place to live. Wherever possible, family units are preserved at the children's home. But because Carolyn was several years younger than Janice, it was soon necessary to move her to the younger children's cottage. Someone had wisely suggested that Janice go along to see the cottage and the room assigned to Carolyn. The house mother welcomed her, and more for the benefit of Janice than for Carolyn, she suggested that they go through the building and she would explain the daily routine of life in the cottage. In the kitchen, meals were planned especially for these younger children, and special dietary problems were met individually. There was a multi-purpose room in the cottage which was used for kindergarten training, indoor activities, and a playroom for the children. There were big dolls here and rockers to rock them in. There were toys too and friends to share them. It was apparent immediately that Carolyn would like her new home very much. Carolyn was assigned to a lovely room. There was even a place for her big doll. She would live here with girls her age and under the supervision of those who would care for her and see to it that her life was as full and complete as love could make it. These workers count it a privilege to serve in this unique kingdom ministry.